The Fairchild Tropical Botanic Garden in Coral Gables has once again teamed up with artist Dale Chihuly to create stunning installations. A few of these glass innovations may cause you to think twice about which is born of fire or sunshine. Join us as we tour the grounds, spotting striking art amongst nature's beauty.
We are here at Fairchild Tropical Botanic Garden, considered to be one of the greatest tropical gardens in the world. And it sits right here in Miami-Dade County. So it's this great gem of a botanical rich heritage. And what we try and do is really create a hub for culture, science, education, and conservation right here in within this wonderful, magical garden, so that everybody can understand how important it is to conserve tropical plants, especially within an urban environment, as well as create cultural richness that allow people to connect with art and nature and music and nature and everything related to the gardens as a muse. Fairchild started its art program in 2005, and our very first art exhibit was Dale Chihuly. And it seemed very appropriate to celebrate our 10th anniversary by bringing Dale Chihuly back to Fairchild. And what makes his medium, which is glass, so wonderful within a garden setting is that it's very malleable. It's very soft. Glass is not soft, but the forms themselves can be very soft. And so you get these great, bold designs, and then you also get these very organic and sinewy pieces that just feel like they're oftentimes considered plants. You don't necessarily know if you're looking at a plant or if you're looking at glass. You're required to take a more careful look. And that's really great for both an art person as well as a plant person, because you're forced to look at things that perhaps you would have walked by. And it allows us to perhaps highlight certain things on a more subjective level. Dale Chihuly is considered the foremost glass artist in the world, an artist of all artists, and a true lover of his craft. And so he has worked with the medium of glass for over 45 years. In fact, this installation represents every series that he's ever had. But more than anything, he's a creative spirit. And he's always pushing himself, and he's always pushing his team, and always bending things in a way that perhaps can't be done, and then finding a way to get that across beautifully and poetically. And he always describes his style as one very elemental: gravity, fire, oxygen. And you have those elements and you can create pretty much anything, as he says it. So right behind me is a polyvitro chandelier, one of Dale's not glass sculptures. And polyvitro is really just Italian for polyurethane glass. As you can see, this piece is quite large. It's probably 25 feet large, and something that big would be exorbitantly heavy in glass. So he created polyvitro as a way to be able to do these great grand scale sculptures, but still have them be practical. What you have over to my right, when you pan over, you're gonna see the beautiful Sol del Citron, which is a piece that was made specifically for Fairchild. And what it does is that it really is very sensitive to this beautiful allée. And allée is a French word for alley, essentially. And the garden designers wanted the sense of mystery. So you're walking down this dark allée, dappled light, and then you open up this great big keyhole. And that keyhole is bright and lit and sun-stricken. And so you get this sense of expansiveness. You're gonna get pieces that sit within the air garden that are very, you know, tough, very rigid, very stout. And they're designed to look very much like an air garden, very much in keeping with xeriscaping. And then you get into the rainforest, which is significantly more romantic and sensual, and you get pieces that move, and pieces that are much more discreet and less aggressive and less angry, for lack of a better word. The Nejima floats sit within the Victoria Pool, and what makes them really special is that they're the largest blown glass piece that Dale produces. And they're incredibly hard to blow. I think the statistic is something like 85% shatter. So the success rate of blowing these massive orbs is really not great. But it's worth the wait because the results are so spectacular. The daytime exhibition is really quite striking because what you get is this great relationship between plant and human interaction and glass interaction, art interaction, very obviously. and except perhaps in the rainforest where you have a little more, you know, organic touches. But you definitely feel the perspectives, and you definitely feel embeddedness of the glass within the collections of plants, which is really quite remarkable. But the night exhibitions are really quite a different feel, because what you get is this luminescence within the garden, within the sculptures, and they glow in the most spectacular way. You have to see it to be able to describe it. It's not enough to see it in the daytime, and it's not enough to see it at nighttime. You have to see the whole thing, because it's a 24-hour experience for certain. The Bailey Palmglade is really the most formal spot in the entire garden. The garden was designed in an east-west access, and you have tuckaways, you have less formality, and then you have great formality within the Bailey Palmglade. Then you have this great long aisle, a great long view that opens up to the lowlands and onto the lakes of the reflective blades of the palms. So the Bailey Palmglade is just this incredible work structured within a lot of stone, a lot of bend, a lot of softness, and you have a big blue orb overhead, very soft, very rounded, in keeping with the sensitivity and the lack of straight lines of the Bailey Palmglade. Dale is also a masterful canvas artist, and we have a great installation of his work within the new building that we just opened in early December. And you can find about 15 or so of his works in there, as well as smaller pieces that are much more portable and gracing people's homes nowadays. That gallery is always open, and it's really quite beautiful. There's an introductory video of Dale's work. It's just a really nice way to introduce yourself to him, to his installation, to his thought process. You see behind the scenes footage of him blowing glass. The process is really quite fascinating when then you see the end result. I think it would be fair to say that the overwhelming response to this exhibition is, oh my God, this is the greatest thing I've ever seen. For 10 years since the very first Chihuly exhibition of Fairchild, there hasn't been a day that's gone by where somebody hasn't asked, is Dale Chihuly's work here? When is Chihuly coming back to Fairchild? That's how much it resonated with people, how connected they felt to those works. And so in general, it's exuberance, it's joy, it's the sense of wonderment that only a great work of art and only a great garden, perhaps together, can give you a sense of things are right. All in all, it's been incredibly well received.
To find out more about the Chihuly exhibition, visit fairchildgarden.org.